is very interesting. It is, okay, it seems to be globally, but de facto, it's measuring the density of network of a very precise set of people. And last but not least, what is very interesting, through time, you have different alliances. When I began to work, the core discipline was mathematical economics, because mathematical economists do one general theory. As you can observe, you have a steady trend of statisticians. Again, statisticians are technicians. From the beginning, the economists have been developing techniques. And with financial deregulation, you have the main ally of economists are financiers, with a small rise of political sense as a compassive millennialism, which is, again, very interesting. The main alliance of contemporary economists is with finance, and the outsider a little bit political sense, but without any relation with, in the term of density of citation, with the rest of the social sciences. And of course, why do very talented American economists go to business school? Because they earn more. They can be consultants. So the other paper by Marion Vocal explain why the shift to neoclassical theory has been made in business school, which is a very important phenomenon in the marketization of knowledge. And of course, then the problem is very difficult, the egg and the chicken. Are people becoming economists because they are accepting self-interest, or they become egoists because they become economists? And again, which is very interesting, when you have a prisoner dilemma gameplay with astronomers and mathematicians, they defect, they cooperate much more than economists, which is interesting. Clearly, you have a kind of habitus formation of economists. And of course, why do